Well, alrighty now. It is Thursday, September 28th. I am a little bit bleary-eyed this morning. But I'm going to be alright. I've got 1,000 words to write. It's kind of, you know, this is kind of my game. I've been thinking about, hey, wouldn't that be cool to make my feed a little more interesting here? But, doesn't matter. This is just my own personal game, and I'm going to be working on chapter 2 today, and try to get that 1,000 words done. I'm having this revelation now that every day I have to read like all the news about what's happening with generative AI. And since I started this book, there are already a number of things that I've written in the book that are no longer true. So one of these days I'm going to go back and start fixing the things that aren't true anymore, or maybe I'll just wait until the end of the, until I get to the editing process, and then I'll be able to go back and start fixing the things that aren't true anymore, that have changed. And it's going to be, I mean, it's going to be a good book, it's going to be a useful book, but it's a real challenge to figure out how to balance what is sort of current and up to date with just trying to find things that are like going to stick around and be true no matter whether it's now or a year from now. But anyway, things change. My only job here is to write 1,000 words every day. I figured yesterday that 1,000 words every day for 70 days will get this book done. And then I'll be done about 2 months ahead of my deadline. Cool. So, I don't know where I'm starting today. I thought I might go right into the hands-on exercise. And there is a that's a pretty good section, actually. I'm happy about it. There's a section I'm missing here that this is one of those things that has changed in the last few days. And so H2, I'm going to say this is like chatting. So Copilot now has this chat interface. Oh, this link doesn't work. This. Get rid of that. There's all this stuff. What does that do? Oh. back how it was. Dang it. How do we get back to how it was? Do I just clear? Instructions. Alright, I can get these instructions back and get a screenshot if I go into Windows. So this is going to be figure 2-8. Oh, cool. So this is pretty cool. So I can talk about how it has some sort of shortcuts built in. Slash commands, that's what they're called. This an H3 slash commands. Pilot chat has several slash commands built into it. These are shortcuts you can use to somehow, you know, I'm always I don't know, switching between Windows and Mac and Linux makes me be like backslash. So a backslash is that one. So forward slash character is the one I want. Does it have another name? No, it's just a forward slash. We'll call it the chat input. So fans and other things to do with GitHub chat. Copilot chat? It's probably Copilot chat. Copilot chat. Okay. Yeah, so these are important things to mention. It's like making the most of GitHub chat. Of I should do something a little fun here, I think. I don't think this is going to work exactly. Okay, I'll do two conversations. I'll do one where I have an imaginary conversation with a person, and then one where I have that same conversation with Copilot Chat. And what you're going to find is that Copilot Chat is going to be like the most talkative programmer you've ever encountered. Which could be funny. File with a problem. What's this? So I need some code. Let's think about this for a moment. So this is the advanced React course that I am delivering next week. And it's got this social media app. Inside of it, there's a client, there's a server. I think I can take this server and use maybe this whole darn thing. So I'm going to take this whole darn thing. Maybe I'll just work with it here. Well, no, I don't want to mess with this. Alright, so I'm going to Visual Finder. And then go like that. And put it into here. Lovely. Oh. That's a good idea. That's not the answer I wanted. But actually, let's go with this, because this will be funny. Thank you. use this super test. Oh, sweet. has something clever to say here. Let's look at something else on the internet just for fun. It's a pretty good day today. It's not raining like crazy like it was yesterday. And I woke up a little bit earlier today, so I'm calmer than I was yesterday. Yesterday I was kind of in a tizzy. Let's see. There's this cool thing that I just installed the new. Wait, is that working now? I just installed the new Mac OS version, and it's got this feature on this overlay thing. Presenter overlay. I'm kind of curious about how this works. Wait, say what? Hey, look, I'm in the little window. What is that? Oh, I see. So if I That's kind of neat. Can I change the position of this thing? Can I change the position of my head? I can stick myself down into this little corner and it looks kind of cornball. Make myself huge like that, but then what do I do? How do I move my screen thing? Or how do I move my head? What's this? Oh. I might use this when I teach next week. Kind of dig this, but I mean, it makes it hard for y'all who might actually want to see what I'm typing to see that, but y'all doesn't really exist. I've got a green screen over here, and that'll probably make everything look even cooler, but I'd need to spend some time, like, actually mounting the green screen. It's like a pull-down thing.
So,
Well, let's try something different here. This is my keyboard. That's so okay. So, yeah, then it has to refigure out stuff. So, if I collect that. That ain't too bad. I wonder what's it look like if I move this over here. Does that look better? I mean, there's not really a reason why I need to be so huge, but it's kind of silly for me to be, hello, in a little circle here. Well, I'm gonna try messing around with this some. This is, it's kinda neat. What is this thing? Full screen. I don't know. I wonder what it will say. Maybe I'll ask it. Well, in the windows. Oh, shoot. What was the exact question? Do you have time? Do you have time to help me fix something in my code? Oh. Nice. Actual short response. Actual conversation copilot, but edited it in parts for length. To remove a lot, edit in parts. Say me. If I do that here. If it will say, I don't know what you're talking about, please open some kind of a file. So I'm going to commit what I've got here. Lovely. And then pull it over here. This is fun today. You're run by somebody else, jerk face. That's not even true. Oh. Because I'm storing it on my Mac. Well, that's just dumb. Let's get something else. I'm going to do a new window. And I'm going to clone that repo. Keeps thinking I'm not signed into GitHub, but I actually am. And then I'm gonna save this on my PC. So in documents. That is not right. Local disk C. Users, Chris Minnick. Code, source, get Chris. There, that's where I want. And I just want to open it. Still things are not signed into GitHub. Okay, good. Things are cleared up now. So, got my repo, got my social media thing, and go back here and I can ask it the question that is on my mind, which is, I'm going to do this with no context, and then hopefully what it's going to do is tell me, yeah, tell me what in the world you're talking about, and I'd be happy to help you. What seems to be the issue? And so now I'm going to ask it what my question is, which is the same as before, except I have not opened any files. And we're going to see how it does with that. I'm not sure. Could you show? Ah, I love it! That's perfect. My cat just got into a fight. I'm going to pause things here and go see. I just heard a yowl out there. So I'll be back. She's fine, but maybe a little shaken. Stopping the stream. I'll be back in half an hour.